Hey there everyone, Rajat here, back again with yet another video. So if you are learning any sort of programming language, you might have heard these two terms, stack and heap. And oftentimes it may have confused you, like what is the difference between the two. So in today's video, we are going to briefly talk about the same. So let's talk about what these two things are. So let's start with the stack memory. Okay, so whenever you call a function, that function is going to create some sort of a space in the memory, and that space of memory is known as the stack memory, because it is only going to contain some data of definite size. Okay, so if you want to store some sort of variables, local variables to the functions, like some sort of boolean variables or integer variables or float variables, and these things are of definite size, and the sizes are defined in the programming specification, right? So these are of definite size. So basically these things can go on the stack. So if you do not know about the stack data structure, it is more like the stack of plates, where you are going to put plates one over other. But if you want to take one plate, then you have to pick only the topmost plate. Okay, so if you want to take one plate out of that stack of plates, you can only pick the topmost plate. You cannot draw any random plate from the middle or from the bottom. Okay, so it is more like that. Okay, so your local variables get pushed onto the stack one after other. Okay, and these are of definite size, so there is not much overhead with storing these variables and fetching them. Okay, so stack memory is of definite size and it can contain some smaller amount of data. But let's suppose your program wants to store some bigger amount of data, like you want to create a string. In that case, what your program or what your programming language runtime is supposed to do, it is going to go out to the operating system and it is going to request the operating system that it needs the operating system to find a random block of memory from the available pool where it can store that sort of data. So then your operating system goes out to the memory and look for a block of memory where that sort of data can be stored. Okay, once it has found that particular block of memory, the pointer to the very first block, okay, of memory is returned by the OS over to your program, and then your program is going to store this particular pointer. It is going to store the pointer of the first block of this heap memory in its stack, and then whenever your program needs to do something with the data stored in this heap memory, it can just read the pointer and go over to the desired location and then do its processing. So this sort of memory is known as heap memory. Okay, so whenever you want to create some bigger amount of data or some random amount of data, it is going to be allocated on the heap memory, and if the condition requires, the heap memory can also be scaled. Let's suppose you want to create some bigger string out of some smaller strings, then as per the runtime, it can do several modifications to the heap memory, and then it can expand or shrink the heap memory as the condition requires. Okay, so this is the major differentiation between the two types of memory. Stack can only contain some definite amount of data which is of definite capacity. Okay, so now the question arises that is there any sort of difference between this heap memory and the heap data structure? And yes, there is a difference. These two things are fundamentally very different and there is no relation between the two. So heap data structure has nothing to do with heap memory. Heap memory can be programmed using a heap data structure, but as per my research, there are better ways to do the heap memory thing. So heap data structure is not used to do the heap memory management. So these are totally different things. Now also keep one thing in mind that every language sorts of implement these stack and heap memories as per the specifications. So those specifications can vary from one programming language to other programming language. So just do not automatically assume that if stacks or heap memories are designed in one particular way in C++, then it is going to be the same case for JavaScript. It is totally dependent upon how the compiler designer, how the language designer feel about implementing these memories. So these memories implementations can vary from language to language. Just do not automatically assume things on your own. You have to really look into the documentation of your compiler and of your runtime in order to know how these two memories are organized and how these two memories are used in your program. But yeah, the general overview is gonna remain the same. Okay, so if you have some more free time, maybe you want to check the stack versus heap documentation from the Rust documentation, because I think that these guys have nailed when it comes to describing the difference between the two. If you have some free time, go download the Rust setup on your system and then just open up the Rust book, okay? And then on chapter 4 under 4.1 heading, you will find this excerpt, okay? So you can read this, and I think that this is the bestest possible explanation you can find on the internet regarding the two. I have given you a quick overview of what the differences are, but if you really want to drill down to the basics, I think you should totally read it. And in case you like this video, do not forget to give this video a thumbs up. In case you want to see more such videos about computer science stuff, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and you chime in with your opinions in the comment section, because hey, when you guys engage with the content, it really motivates me to produce more stuff. Otherwise, it is all crickets and nobody wants to upload content for crickets. If the audience is there, then the content is going to come. Okay, with that, we have reached the conclusion of this video. I see you guys over in the next video. Take care. Bye.